This week alone, at least three security operatives have been shot and killed across the country. Mental Health Uganda counselors have expressed concern that the gun violence that has rocked the country and caused fear is linked to mental illnesses. A mental disorder can be caused by stress, and security operatives are no exception. It's why they are calling for an urgent attention by the government to the mental health needs in armed forces.
Provide psychosocial support to these people. Let us give a complaint area where you can raise the complaints in a forum. Because I know into the ACT, we find that actually in the constitution, we find that we have the area where you can develop a consultative consultative meetings. Let us utilize that area.
The question, however, is on whether the police or the army can be able to detect any signs of mental illness among the officers during the time of recruitment. The mental health counselors raised the concern today as patients received free treatment at the medical camp in Mutungo, a Kampala suburb. Mental health services were prioritized, and a special call was made to the Ministry of Finance to channel more funds to the Butabika Mental Hospital to scale up specialized mental services.
Let us increase the funding or the finances of mental health units, because government has done its part, but let them increase, because we are finding that we are also having the specialized hospital at Butabika. But the number is overwhelming.
Meanwhile, patients with different ailments in the slum areas of Nakawa Division overwhelmed this free medical camp, which was organized by the Rotary Club of Bugolobi. Though they had planned for 1,000 patients, they were overwhelmed. They received over 3,000, and most of them presented with advanced symptoms.
Turn-up is very okay, and the demand is very high. It is only that the number has overwhelmed. We expected about 500 to 1,000, but we are beyond 1,000 right now.
There are over 3,000 clients who have been here. We have treated them in line of many services, dental care, eye care, family planning, immunization, safe medical circumcision, dispensing drugs. The services have been so many. We have had over 3,000 clients, but all of them have been attended to.
Some of the patients who benefited from this free treatment commended Rotarians for the big heart, disclosing that though they had been diagnosed for years, they had failed to get treatment because they didn't have money. Many of us are badly off. We can't afford to pay for treatment. So when we hear about free medical camps, we turn up in large numbers. We don't even support government scrapping the free medical treatment in their hospitals. We are low-income earners. This story was compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.